Bakers and Bakers. I'm Sienna.
I'm Willa.
And today we're going to show you how to make tie-dye.
Okay, the first step is to, if you have new clothes, then you should wash them first.
Yeah.
And then after you wash them, you're going to wet them.
Yeah.
And then we would recommend the Mondo Llama thing from Target. And there's 8 colors and 3 aprons and 3 pairs of gloves. And whenever you have the bottles of the stuff, it'll just be like the stuff where you have to add water to it. And after you add water to it, you shake it really well. And whenever you're done, you can take technique you want to do. So you can do like a striped tie-dye, a crumple tie-dye technique, a rainbow tie-dye, or a spiral of it.
I'm doing swirl.
And so I have a t-shirt, a pair of socks, and shorts, and Willa has 2 crop tops. And so I'm gonna do the stripe technique, the crumple, and the spiral. And Willa's gonna do the spiral and then the crumple. Okay, the first one I'm gonna do is the spiral tie-dye. Lay it flat to make sure it has to be flat. And then you have to grab the middle of it and start just swirling it, kind of. Stuck. Interruption. I think it wasn't the best surface to do on it, but now I have it swirled up. And after that, you grab your rubber band, and I'm probably gonna do 6. Whenever you have the 6th one. Okay, I fixed rubber bands on. This is what it will look like whenever it's done. Yeah. Okay, now we're gonna get our colors. What, Willa, what colors do you want?
Red.
Red?
Blue.
I'm gonna do blue too. What color, blue? This one?
Yeah. Okay.
There. Is that what you want? Purple? Oh.
Can you hold these, please? Yeah.
Ooh, that one's really cool.
Oh, yep. That one is.
Okay. And I'm gonna do this teal blue and then the darker teal blue. Okay, you don't have to use 6 rubber bands. I just felt comfortable with doing it because it might be better tight. But Willa's gonna be doing red, blue, pink, and purple. Okay, so you're gonna do it. Make sure the colors are not really close together. It might become muddy if you have them really close together. So try to keep them right by the rubber band. So think this is good right here. And now I'm just gonna do a pattern, and I'm gonna do the other color blue. For this after. Then you have to repeat on the back side. Can't get it back on. Okay. Luna. It doesn't have to be perfect, because if it's too much, then it might get muddy, like I said. Okay, now moving on to the other side. First color in my pattern, now I just need to finish my other color. So I'm trying to make sure it's not going to get muddy. Okay, I finished my swirl. Whenever Willa's done, I'm going to wait for her and almost done. That was really good, Willa. Make sure you get the front and the back. Okay. And I'm going to give it back to Willa and Willa. Because whenever you're done, you put it in there to let it dry. We're going to move on to the next one. Okay, my next one is going to be my shorts. Yeah, I'm going to tie that. Okay, this is the crumple technique. So, what you have to do is, you grab your shorts, her shirt is over there. Grab your shirt. You can just crumple it up any kind of way, anything like that, maybe fold it a little bit, okay. put about maybe 4 rubber bands on my shorts, and Willa will probably put 4 rubber bands on her shirt. Got this almost done. Said, make sure it's not really close together so it doesn't get muddy. I'm adding the pattern, short.
Nothing.
Why we wear apron. Okay, my first pattern. I'm gonna do one of these. Now I'm gonna get my yellow. I'm gonna look for the yellow first.
What colors are you going to use?
I'm going to use blue.
Blue, okay.
Just blue?
Yeah.
Pink.
Pink.
Good. Is that it?
Blue, pink, and
sweet. Okay, I'm gonna get my yellow in. Really good. Don't want it to get overlapped with green. Blend like that. Okay, going to the other side. Thank you. at a time, and for the stripe, grab this, and if for socks, you don't really have a choice, but if you want to do, if you have a shirt or shorts or something, you can do it either way. If you want it going up and down, you do that way. If you want it going side to side, you do it like that. Doing the socks, stripe. Done? Whoa, that looks so cool. Okay. I'm just going to be using three. So I'll have, you can have a pattern, or I might just use all different colors for that. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So I have 4 spaces to do. Okay, I'm gonna use, I think, red. Red, purple, and pink. Yeah, okay. Okay, so this is pink, and I'm going to do, just gonna put it all over this. So this one's just harder to get muddy because, it's not really overlapping each other. First one, it's red, pink or something. Now I'm going to do red and orange. Mm-hmm. Oh, and I also forgot to say this. You do not want to mix green, orange, and purple together.
Yeah, it'll make a muddy color.
Brown. Yeah. And that will not... And you don't want that on your tie dye.
No. Okay.
Oh, stripping.
Red box, cool.
Okay. Gonna add that much more. Okay. Got red. Now I'm gonna use a purple, maybe. Finished one sock. Now,
gotta do the other sock.
Yeah. Wait, I forgot to put this one in too.
Yeah, that one's cool.
What?
That's cool.
There we go. And you might want to separate these because they'll mix together, and then it'll just, because I think I'm going to do different colors on them, so I'll do the rest of the other colors. Okay. Now, the rest of the other colors are green, blue, and another blue, and yellow. Okay. I'm going to start with the yellow. My sock. Wait, first. Oh, I have to. We have to put the rubber bands on first. And I'm gonna do 4 like I did on the last one. Okay. I might want to move it up a little bit more. mix them on mini makers and bakers. Hope your tie dye turns out very well. Bye. One day later, the instructions said to leave our shirts out for 6 to 8 hours, but we did a full day. And you have to make sure to wash it and dry it, and make sure you, and this is how it turned out, and make sure to subscribe to our video and like it, and bye. See you next time on Mini Makers and Bakers.